The Way of Peaceful Warrior by Dan Millman. Main message: lose your self-importance and adopt a strategy of unreasonable happiness. The Way of the Peaceful Warrior has the appearance of a lightweight novel for teenagers, but by the end of you realize that it contains many spiritual truths. This, combined with the simple enjoyment of a story that includes romance and high adventure, has made it a bestseller. Socrates takes Dan through a series of mental and physical trials that use up all his energy. Their purpose is to reveal to him his illusion, the thing that he chases for ego's sake. Cutting himself free from the illusion, Socrates tells him, will require more courage and strength than any movie hero. Dan realizes why he loves gymnastics, because he is going through his routine. He is just doing, not thinking. It is holiday from his mind. But Socrates sees that these changes are all superficial, a protection from a real willingness to change his thoughts. In contrast, Dan is a serious jackass who thinks he knows a few things, but in reality is sleepwalking through life. His mentor starts him on a program of awakening. Dan is told that he is like most people in that he has been taught to get his information from outside himself, and the result is that his mind is like the gas tank of a car, overflowing with preconceptions full of useless knowledge. Socrates teaches that the best way to clear the cluttered mind is through meditation. Meditation is the sword of peaceful warrior, he says, which cuts the mind to ribbons, slashing through thoughts to reveal their lack of substance. The warrior acts and the fool only reacts. There is an I doing it, but when you meditate your action, they are powerful and free because they don't have ambition or fear weighing them down. We perceive things as good luck or bad luck, or as a loss or gain, but the character of Socrates represents the Eastern idea that we should be the same in failure or success. We think of failure as being bad reality and success as good reality, but it is all reality. This does not mean that we forget about trying to improve things or create better habits. We exist for these purposes. It means rather that we need to forge a new friendship with reality. However, through Socrates, he discovered that the only way to have peace of mind and really to love life is to have a philosophy of unreasonable happiness.